Joan never slowed down. She had more than 24 dates actually booked in the months ahead, but now she is fighting for her life. So how did such a routine procedure lead to this? Well, Entertainment Tonight's top story is Joan Rivers, A Life in the Balance.
There's always the risk. Whenever you go under, you've got to say, maybe this won't work, or maybe I won't even come out of it. I mean, it is a major life choice.
Prayers for Joan Rivers today. As of our deadline, she remains in a medically induced coma and is fighting for her life.
This medically induced coma is to stabilize everything, to get everything back to normal functioning. And I assume in the next couple of days, they'll take her off the anesthesia and see if she wakes up.
ET Special Correspondent Chris Raggi is outside Mount Sinai Hospital.
Joan's daughter, Melissa, has been here at the hospital by her mother's side all day. Last night, in a statement, Melissa thanked everyone for their overwhelming love and support.
Melissa added today that her mother's condition, quote, remains serious.
We now know Joan was at an Upper East Side clinic for a routine endoscopy when early in the procedure, she stopped breathing. The question on the minds of many today is, how could something like this happen?
Having anesthesia at a certain age puts you at a greater risk.
Dr. Suzanne Steinbaum is a cardiologist.
When I think of Joan Rivers, she's just such a ball of energy. You just forget her age. And the truth is, at 81 years old, no procedure is really a simple procedure.
Joan had a show booked for tonight, which has obviously been canceled. We spoke with one of her fans, Adam Rothenberg, who was at her performance Wednesday night.
I saw the headlines that she was in the hospital. I immediately thought of her joke that she does during the show, how she's, you know, 81 years old. And could you imagine if she dropped dead during the show? You know, you would have a story for the rest of life.
To get a sense of just how driven she is.
Good morning, good morning. This is great.
Just 2 months ago, we tagged along for a day with Joan on her book tour. She was always cracking jokes.
We are in store for, I'm in store for suing New York City. I think Coco Chanel is not going to be happy about that one.
And she's grateful for her fans.
Why isn't that funny?
Because you've got it on video.
Oh, my goodness.
Who are these people?
They're here to see you, the audience.
They have nothing better to do?
No.
On a Monday?
No, they're all
excited. These are all unemployed.
And then she's on air.
Well, very few people have threatened to have the mafia. And if they do, I'll shut up. Well, I'm going to fight with Kanye West if he's you shut the I'll shut
And she's off, caffeine in hand, to the Russian Tea Room, where she's asked about her celebrity insults.
Regardless of legal actions, do any of them ever come up to you privately and say you really hurt my feelings? Or you?
No, I don't think I've ever really hurt anybody's feelings.
We step outside, and Joan takes over our camera.
What would be the best thing to happen to you today?
Meeting you today.
What would be the worst thing to happen to you today?
Meeting you.
How do you keep the stamina up and the energy up when you have so many interviews all day long?
Well, the stamina really is up because of drugs. But also, it's up because I really think the book is funny and people are liking it.
And Joan knows how to sell it. After a quick hit at MTV, we go back to her New York penthouse for one last prim.
But we're going to a book site, right? And that's, and then that will be the end of today. And then we start again tomorrow morning in full hair and makeup. What time?
8 o'clock.
8 o'clock for hair and makeup?
Mm-hmm.
Yes. That's not bad.